And our own Jim Avil will be part of that Fusion launch tomorrow. He speaks with President Obama at the White House. We're going to have that tomorrow on Fusion. Also, now I want to welcome Jorge Ramos, already the lead anchor at Univision. He'll be taking on new duties at Fusion tomorrow as well. You're going to have about three or four jobs, I think, Jorge. But you believe this is critical, this Fusion launch.
Only three. But you can do it too, George. If you can do it, I can do it.
Tell us about Fusion and really what you're trying to do here.
I think the future is about fusion, and fusion is about the future. Who controls the future? It's about the future of news. It's a great partnership between ABC News and Univision, a content based on news, entertainment, pop culture, sports, comedy. As you know, for a young audience, we're trying to reach a very young audience. For them, the traditional definition of news is no longer valid. So for them, news could be from a tweet to a video, to a revolution, to a war. But also we want to reach people, it doesn't matter the age, who's a little tired of the traditional network, the traditional media. So in order to reach that, we also have to reach Latinos. And you know, right now there are 55 million Latinos. In 30 years from now, there are going to be 150 million Latinos. So the future is about exactly that, how to reach that part of the audience. And that's exactly what we want to do with Fusion.
Well, we're looking forward to working with you. I wish we had more time right now, but we don't. But we want you to come back and talk about it more, talk about a lot else. Jorge, thanks very much. It's time now for our Sunday Spotlight, shining on Joshua Dubois, who had the job every morning of finding the right scriptures to help ground a president. And as he told our Cokie Roberts, it's a job he volunteered for without knowing how President Obama would respond.
I want to say a quick word about a close friend of mine and yours, Joshua Dubois.
When he was just 26 years old, Pentecostal minister Joshua Dubois took on the job of White House outreach to the religious community.
Every morning, he sends me via email a daily meditation. It has meant the world to me.
I was wondering, you know, who was thinking about his spirit? Who was thinking about his soul? Instead of praying for him privately, why don't you reach out to him and send him an email with a word of encouragement? Within a few minutes, he wrote back and said, this was exactly what I've been looking for.
Dubois is now sharing some of those daily doses of inspiration in a new book, The President's Devotional.
You only once in the book tell us that you picked one for a specific day. Yeah. And that was the day the president was to deliver the State of the Union message. Can you read us that one?
Sure. So shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it.
Were you worried that he wouldn't be understood?
Well, there's just so much noise in our culture today. There's so many different sources of distraction and folks who either intentionally or unintentionally desire to muddle the true meaning of what we say.
So I notice an awful lot of the readings are love your enemy, feed your enemy, hold peace. Do you think these are particularly necessary for a president?
I think they're necessary for all of us, really. Just from a practical perspective, it's so much better to learn to love our enemies. We'll be able to get so much more done.
This is one that I think should be on needle-pointed on cushions in everyone's offices.
Yes. Even a fool is counted wise when he holds his peace. When he shuts his lips, he is considered perceptive.
There you go.
But the president cannot hold his peace when he's needed to speak, as a nation mourned after an unthinkable tragedy.
I can only hope it helps for you to know that you're not alone in your grief.
You describe going to Newtown as probably the most searing experience.
The president wanted me to go with him to meet with the families backstage before his speech and try to give some level of comfort to them. There were a number of parents who had pulled out the school pictures that they had just taken,
right,
and pointed to them, and then just collapsed, and the president just had to hold them. I was proud of him, but I was also one of those moments where I was really kind of just concerned for his spirit, because it has to take a lot out of a person.
Making that daily boost of spiritual encouragement all the more meaningful.
Do you think it made him different?
I would hope that he was able to tackle challenges that he faced with a greater measure of peace, knowing that God loves him, knowing that no matter what's happening on any given day, what's happening in the news cycle, there's an eternal God whose arms are wrapped around him, and that that love cannot be shaken. So yeah, I think it did.
For this week, Cokie Roberts, ABC News, Washington.
Thanks to Cokie for that, and now we honor our fellow Americans who serve and sacrifice. This week, the Pentagon released the name of one Marine killed in Afghanistan. And that is all for us today. Thanks for sharing part of your Sunday with us. Check out World News with David Muir tonight. I'll see you tomorrow on GMA.